everybody, waiting for people to join in. Hopefully someone will give a thumbs up. Hey, Lucy Wild, you want to just give me a thumbs up that you can hear me? Send a little thumb or heart. Amazing. Oh, so nice seeing all your names pop up. All these people. Lots of my English friends and people. So, welcome to this space, this shared space. Welcome to my space here. I'm in Brazil. The sun is just setting over the mountain. I'm looking out. You can see the palm trees there. You probably hear the birds singing away in the background. And I'm just gonna start with a song. More words will come later, but welcome everybody. I'm gonna move this incense. Thank you. along right now with these songs. Maybe we send a wave of, I don't know what the options are, hearts or smiley faces. That you can all be singing along from your homes and you don't need to worry about being embarrassed if anyone can hear you. There's 336 of you watching me and listening and sharing this space together right now. I'm really touched just seeing all of your messages and all these hearts. Actually moves me to tears. Oh, just feeling these people feeling you all of us around the world on our web. On our little place in the strand of this amazing web across the whole world, and these people, all these names, you look, Sheila and Joanna, and people I know from all different countries, and my English family, and amazing, really amazing. Thank you so much for being here in this moment. I've never done a Facebook Live concert, and it's kind of weird feeling. But I really feel you all, and I think it's so beautiful this that we can learn, like through our technology, through our phones and our internet, we can be reminded of our kind of telepathic, energetic web that we have spreading across this world, and how we're all in connection with each other, and especially all of us in our kind of isolated little homes, how important it is if we can't have that direct contact to be in touch with each other. So yeah, hi everybody. Wow. Bit overwhelmed. So for those of you who are at home in a quiet space right now, I'm gonna just have a moment of silence that I'm inviting you to all be part of, to just arrive into this space. I know for me it's been a bit frantic to get to this moment, and with my baby and making sure everything's working. So let's give ourselves that gift to just, however you are, if you're lying down or sitting down or cooking dinner or I don't know what you might be doing, but turn inwards, just close your eyes for a moment, turn your inward looking, your eyes looking inwards, to just arrive here and acknowledge that you are sitting here somehow in a shared room with 406 people all around the world. 406 people living on this one planet, sharing this one moment, this strange, difficult, crazy moment that we're all together in. Imagining like a threads of light, like on this spider web. Just imagine all those threads spreading out, connecting to all of those people, all around the earth. And actually that web goes through all the beings here. So this is my offering to us all in this moment. This is the thing I know how to give, how to do, to sing, to share these songs and these prayers. Please, please sing along from your homes. Please join in, sing wildly, dance, lie down, cry, laugh, do whatever you feel you need to do to, and really give yourself permission to drop into this moment, to really relax your body, get really comfortable. Relax your nervous system, go into that rest and that stillness within.
Thank you.
lie down and get really comfortable. We have two real human beings with me in the room, just telling them to get comfortable, but you guys also welcome to get comfortable. Wow, I want to like ask you all how you do it. How's everyone doing? How's it going? How are you in your bodies? How are you in your minds, in your hearts, and your souls, and that ocean of emotions of being a human being, especially in this intense moment. I'm going to share with you a pretty new song that I have written here during my time. I'm in a very beautiful place in Brazil, a beautiful land called Alto Paraíso. A lot of many hundreds and hundreds of waterfalls and streams and rivers and land of really pure water, and I spend time with the rivers asking. So these messages is really distracting. Thanks for all your beautiful messages. I'm going to read them afterwards. So this song came from a moment I felt very, very confused, sitting by the water and just again and again sitting by the rivers, how they remind us that we are like the waters, we are like the rivers, that our life is like that journey towards the ocean, even when it's going here and there and round and in these strange directions. And it feels very much like that right now, like something like this that feels so scary and such crisis and brings so much suffering and a lot of pain, a lot of loss, a lot of grief, a lot of fear. And somehow to find that deep, deep trust in our being, that is the course that the river needs to take through that valley, around that corner, to find its way to the ocean. And that remembrance for me, that when I sit by moving water, that it's when water is moving, it's only ever going towards the ocean. Even if the ocean is that way and the river is going that way, it's still on its way to the ocean. And somehow, as a mass, we are on that journey now, but also each individual soul returning back home to the ocean.
No more holding on, release.
Wow, there's 700 people. I love each one of you. So I want to honor some of the requests. It's really lovely having specific requests from people. And I'm sorry if anyone requests a song and I don't sing it during this little sharing. Maybe I'll do another one again and cover them all. But I'm just following the flow of the song, so I will see what wants to come now. I will sing, quite a few of you requested I Call You. Which is really lovely because I don't sing it, I hardly sing it anymore. It feels quite relevant. This is a song that's just calling in the many expressions of the forces of divinity and the forces of creation, the visible and the invisible. And it's a good moment now with everything that's going on for us to remember to call upon our allies. Within ourselves, outside of ourselves, all across this earth, to call it in for each other. to the buzzard and the hawk. Teach me to ride on the wind. The waves pounding at my shore. Teach me what surrender means. Spirit of the deer, I call you. Thank you. Hi everyone. I'm going to share a song called Waniwa Chielo. It's not the Hihaniwashti, in case any of you are going, oh yeah, he's going to sing that one. But it's the same word. Waniwa Chielo is a Lakota word. And as far as I understand, the translation is directly, I want to live. But as I have got to experience these words in many different prayers and experience that energy that they bring, how I understand it is, it's actually I want to live. Like, I don't just want to live life half asleep. I want to live really, really fully. In celebration, in gratitude, in the fullness of my being, in my grief, in my sorrow, in my joy, in my laughter, in all that is every single color of being a human being, because that's what it really means to be alive. Wani wachi yelo. So please join in from your homes. Maybe during the chorus I might kind of go, who's singing, and everyone can do a little bubble, because it's really beautiful that we can feel each other in this way and know that we're all singing together and singing, lifting that prayer, especially in this time when our life is like being squashed into rooms and this like limit to our life. We can't see each other, we can't sing with each other, we can't dance with one another. So how we live really fully, even within this, how we carry this out after this time into our lives as a medicine to bring changes to what to us is not living fully, whatever that may be, from the smallest to the biggest levels. So also during this song, you can contemplate on that. What does it really, really mean for each one of us to really live? Really, really, really live this life, and in doing so, it is a prayer. It is a prayer anyway, but the more we live it, the more it becomes an offering back to life itself.
Life from the heart. Tell me your story. Confide.
secrets, and I will listen to a story that will always last in this moment. In the presence of spirit, I am opening to the presence of spirit. I turn to the wisdom keeper inside of me, one he watch yellow. I turn to the wisdom keeper inside of me, one he watch yellow. Yeah, I think somehow that song leads on to where a lot of my thoughts and feelings have been this past week. I got quite sick with some kind of cold or something and went into my ears, and like illness can be sometimes like an interesting medicine. It took me into the void in my being, I'll say it like that. Like I didn't have energy to do anything, the things that I would normally do to hold myself up. Didn't want to sing, I couldn't do yoga, I couldn't really move around, and I just much went inwards, and I see this as a lot of people are talking about this, going into this void, the unknown, and all that comes with that. And I had this one day where I just felt very disturbed to contemplate what's happening on all the levels and dimensions, what's happening for humanity, what's happening for the earth, for the trees, for the plants, the animals, the waters, the air. And I just felt like spinning, like turning, like this sensation of chaos spinning in this, like spinning without a compass. And so I went and I had a bit of time on my own, which anyone who's a mummy will know is a really special thing. Had a few hours on my own and was really able to go diving into that ocean. And it's like the ocean, when we're above the surface, we're trying to keep above the surface, down below the ocean, it seems so scary, the unknown, the darkness, what the hell is down there? And when I went down, then it was like, wow, okay, here is my grief. Here is my fear. Whoa, oh my God, here's my anger. I'm so angry. Here is all these strange mixture of emotions. And I want to share this with you because I felt like, okay, I'm doing a Facebook Live. All these people are going to watch. What do I have to say about what's happening here? And to say that I don't have any answers, that none of us have any answers, that none of us really know, is definitely the first step. And to see, for me, to make that step into accepting that I have no idea what's going on, where this will lead, when I can leave Brazil, when I can see my family again, how the future for my child is going to look, this great unknown is so scary when I'm resisting it. And the more I've been able to go, whoa, wow, this is a great mystery, and feel all that I'm feeling, go into my numbness, into my emptiness, into that bowl of despair inside my being, and actually feel those feelings, I found that it was leading me really to my heart and leading me to this crossroad where we are faced right now. Do we choose love or do we choose fear? Can we choose love? Or can we only be under that weight of our fear? Can we dare to choose love? And yes, it takes courage, because it's not so easy to feel those things. But for me, I have sensed that through feeling my sadness, through feeling my confusion, through feeling my not knowing, through acknowledging it and really going there and all my honesty into my being, I am choosing love. They are all expressions within the language of the heart. So I just want to share this. This comes with Wani Wachiyelo. And what does it mean to live fully? Does it mean, like, when I've been reading all these beautiful posts about this is like awakening and this is change and be positive and believe and have faith, and I've been like, it sounds amazing, but right now I'm feeling really like not quite feeling that. I'm feeling a lot of stuff that is leading to that place, and that is choosing love. So I wanted to share that. Choosing your sadness, choosing your anger, maybe in that moment choosing love, choosing to feel your numbness, is choosing love. Choosing to go, I'm scared, I'm lonely, I miss my friends, what the hell is going to happen? But it feels good to come home to the heart. So that's where I've been. Yeah. What song? I'm going to sing you a song that actually nobody has heard on this earth so far. It has the words Iyache Ashama in it towards the end. And I've been taught this as people talk about that there was a language in the time before time and the people before peoples. This very, very ancient sacred language. And Iache Ashama. It means, Iache means we are all related, and Ashama is one of the names for the Great Mother. So you're welcome to join in that bit at the end. Choose life. I am opening. I am following the drum that is calling. I know I am held by the truth of life. I am love being born, a flower blooming. We are the seeds of our ancestors' dreams. Prayers that were given to creation. We are life breathing through us, love pouring through us. We hear the earth that is cooling. I allow my breath. Thank you. dedicate a song to my blood family. I think some of you are watching. Zara, Caspian, if you're still awake. Caspian, give me a wave if you're enjoying this music. Thule, I think I saw your name. My mother, my father, I don't know if you're here. Anyway, my blood family. It's quite a thing to be so far away from you in this time, and I just want you to know I feel you every day, and I love you all. And my extended spiritual family, all the people that I don't even know. I really, it's amazing. I have these moments where I feel, Zara, yay. Where I feel this profound sense of being connected to every single human being in this whole planet in a way that I would say I haven't felt it before. And this phrase that is being used a lot of, we are all in this together, it's really quite profound. And yes, it's a crisis, and it comes with a lot of challenge and a lot of sadness, a lot of suffering, but oh look, hello Auntie Isla. Caspian! Yeah, just to tune into that sense of profound connectedness, that truth that we are able to realise and tap into. And something like Facebook Live is quite an amazing way of experiencing that. So this is a very new song, a couple of weeks ago. Thank you. I've no idea how long I've been singing for. It's a bit timeless. The sun is setting here. I hope you can hear all the birds. I think I'm just gonna do a couple more, two more or something. Pregnant, like maybe 8 months pregnant or something, and yeah, what a thing it is to bring children into this time. What a responsibility, what a strong prayer.
To live life in honor and care of the earth. To live life in honor and care of the earth.
I trust that anybody who is watching right now, that you have somewhere in your heart and can feel somewhere in your heart that place that can trust in this journey that we're all on as humanity right now. Can trust in this great healing journey of the earth and the earth's children. We're all here together. I just want to remind us to anchor ourselves, even if it's just a tiny glimmer that we can't even really put into words, or that's overshadowed by other feelings, but to anchor ourselves, to hold on to that thread, that connection to spirit, connection to the earth, to the sky, to our faith, to our prayer. To remember to speak with that place, to keep in dialogue, to remember to pray, to remember ask for guidance on a global level, that we may be guided by all the forces that are guiding us, that we may be able to listen, be brave enough to let go, great letting go, brave enough to grieve the loss, that makes space for change, for rebirth, for transformation, for a new earth to be born. Yes, trusting and love, exactly. And like I said earlier, even if all we can feel is our sadness or our fear, to go in through that thread, follow it. It's love underneath. And sing. Do you have the time? I've no idea. Some tell me what the time is, but maybe not that much.
Six.
Okay. So, actually, I'm going to do two more because my baby's going to come back soon. The nice thing about Facebook Live, it doesn't really matter. There's no venue closing. You can just leave. Oh, someone just, I missed that message. What was it, Aaron and Joshua? They're not here. Who was it? Was it Dory? You just said something. They might come back in a minute.
Guided by knowing from within.
My beautiful friends, so many amazing messages that I can't keep up reading them all. I'm gonna sit and read them all afterwards. Thank you so much. They're so, so sweet. I'm so nourished and so warmed in my heart to see all of these names, people I know, people I don't know. It's really, really, really warmed my heart. Really touched me. Thank you so much for so much love, all of you. Oh. Yeah, I really love you all. I care about each one of you, every single body and heart and mind on this earth. And these are my, this is my offering of love and care and faith and prayer for healing for all of us. My baby's coming. I'm gonna sing one last song. My baby will probably come in the room.
Luz a la luz.
the sunset's gone dark. I'm going to take you guys outside to the sun. Let's see if this works. Just the sun setting. Wow, yeah, 1,000 people. Amazing. Wow. So here you go, everybody. If you can see in the beautiful sky, here is the most beautiful song of all. Here is our altar, our prayer, our mother, our home, our teacher, our guide, who loves us unconditionally, who is teaching us in every single moment what unconditional love really, really means. She loves us, she forgives us, she's guiding us. Helen's asking, can we see Arwen? My baby's not here. Yeah, so I really send you onwards into your evening or wherever you are, whatever time you are, send you onwards with real softness in your heart, real tenderness in your heart with whatever is there, whatever feelings, whatever is in that ocean, those infinite drops, that you can keep that feeling of connection to yourself, that calm in the center of your being. That calm will keep you healthy, keep you protected. I pray that you're safe in this time, that your families are safe, that you are peaceful in your minds, that you find contentment in the moments, that you are able to have moments with the sky. The beautiful moon up there, can't show you the sky and the earth. That you receive that guidance, that you feel your ancestors holding you. That you keep faith, keep trusting, that we keep together, keep strong in this time, this rebirth. I love each one of you. Thank you so much for being here. So sweet. 1,000 people. Lots of love. I'm going to share a link somewhere here at the end where if you feel inspired to make any kind of donation, you can know that anything I receive, I'm going to plant 3 trees for every single donation. And I'm also going to give a link directly to Tree Sisters if you want to make your donation directly to them, that you can plant as many trees as you like through them, and that we can keep this prayer in action. All my love. Bye, everybody.